So I'm not saying that there isn't love afoot in the society, that people don't do selfless and kind and good things. I'm not saying that it doesn't happen or it's not available. I'm saying that those are not the norm, not the bell curve. The majority of people and the majority of the time, those are based when it's something good or seems loving. It's more often than not based on some what do I get out of it motive. And actual love doesn't have that motive. Doesn't seek to satisfy itself. If you want to know if it's real love or not, that's the measure. Does it have an element in it of the person's trying to satisfy themselves? Trying to get something out of it. Oh, they're being so charitable and serving others. Yeah, but are they? Can you see the ego? If you look, you notice ego in it, that like they're kind of holding themselves higher. Oh, I'm serving humanity. If you can see that or sense that, then that's not truly love. That's self-aggrandizement that puts on a coat of love, but it's phony. Yeah, somebody who has a lot of money gives a lot to charity. But why are they doing it? And what they're giving actually doesn't even make a crimp in their bank account. It's not real charity. Yeah, it's good that they give it. It's helping somebody. Some organization is doing good with it. But what's their motive? Is it because they truly want to give, which would be the way of love? Is it from their heart? Something rises up and they want to give it? Or is it so that they can feel, look how wonderful I am, that I donate, that I give, that I help out? And the measure there is it should hurt. If you have 100 million and you give 100,000, that doesn't hurt. That's like I have a dollar and I give a penny. I still have 99 cents. It's not much difference. It doesn't hurt to give that penny. But if I have a dollar and I give 95 cents, that hurts. If it doesn't hurt, then it hasn't really been truly from the heart. Because the heart is generous. When you only have a dollar and the heart says give, it wants to give 95 cents. It doesn't want to give five. And if you follow that, you'll actually give 95 of the 100 pennies. And that will hurt. Your mind will say, oh, maybe I shouldn't have done that. Now I only have a nickel left. But metaphysically, it'll transform you and benefit you and enrich you beyond any measure. You'll get, if you only have a dollar and you give, your heart says give 95 cents to this poor man, and you follow it, you don't ignore it, you don't rail against it and walk away. You give the 95 cents. Keep a nickel for yourself because you need to eat too. But if your heart says give most of it and you follow it rather than logic yourself out of it, you get about $10,000 worth of metaphysical benefit for that in round numbers dollar. So these urges of the heart have to be understood for what they are. They are metaphysical situations. And love always wants to give the most. It's not calculating what can I afford. It wants to give the most. So when you simply have faith in that and follow it, the transformational result for you will be astronomical. And you usually won't know it. Things will come into your life that you won't relate to having given 95 cents of your dollar, but it'll be exactly because of that. Things will open up that weren't possible before. And you will be altered in ways you won't necessarily relate to that. But you'll notice along the way, over the months, over the years after, that, oh, I'm different this way. Oh, now I'm this way. Oh, this is good. But you won't connect the dots and take it back to, oh, 2 years ago when I only had a dollar, I gave 95 cents. But that will be the actual metaphysical operation of it. You will benefit exponentially in amazing, amazing ways. And if you can see the relationship of what happens in your life after, and that faith you acted on of following the urge of the heart, then you'll become a true believer in charity, service, and giving. You'll see that you get a lot from it. But not in an ego way of, look how cool I am. In a way of, wow, this is something that really works. This is how it's set up. You've heard me give this advice before. If you get a strong urge to do something that's a little impractical or inconvenient that involves giving, always follow it. Even if it seems unreasonable, always follow it. It's a metaphysical grand opportunity. Because the natural thought, the natural response, the mind comes in and says, no, that's too much, or you can't afford it, or it's not smart. But that's because the mind does not understand the metaphysical operation of things. So it has no way of making a reasonable evaluation. It's just a naysayer. It just says, oh, come on, that's foolish. Don't do that. Don't listen to that. The wisdom of the heart in that kind of situation is not only superior, it's supreme. What you'll garner from it is immeasurable. I'm only saying that because every time I've done it in my life, every time my heart has said, do this, and I couldn't afford it, and I did it because I knew that it's better to follow it. It completely transformed my life in wonderful ways. I started to see the connection. That's why I can say it to you very confidently, because it's never failed. In small things and big things, whenever there's, let's put it very simply so you can hold on to it and live it. Whenever there's an urge to give in any way, do it. Don't question it, don't analyze it, don't ask yourself, because the mind will automatically start to do this. Well, is it really wise to do this? Don't listen to any of that and short-circuit it and rush to give so that you can't change your mind. Whenever there's the urge to give or the urge to generosity, follow it. That's a divine moment, a transformational opportunity. And it's among the best everyday life, transformational potentials. There's nobody it doesn't happen to. Sooner or later, some moment comes when you, an urge rises up and you give or help. And whenever that happens, the smartest thing you can do is follow it. And don't let anything your mind says prevent you. And the dumbest thing you can do is ignore it or let your mind convince you it's a bad idea. You will never lose, even though after you do it, your mind will try to convince you that was stupid. Now you've lost. You can't lose. And especially when it's about generosity. When someone asks you for $20 and you have the urge to give them $100, and your mind jumps in and says, oh, that's too generous. He's only asking for $20. What do you need to give him five times that? Ignore that. If the urge came right away, give him $100. Give him $100. You will benefit 1,000 times more than he will from the $100, from having given $100 rather than $20. This is metaphysical guarantee. It always works this way. This is simply the way it works. And everybody has these urges. Everybody has these moments where something rises up and says, do that. That involves helping someone, giving in some way. And those are golden opportunities. And most people miss it. Most people ignore or scale it back or talk themselves out of it. And that's unfortunate. Because these are specific opportunities. They're not like anything else. They operate for your metaphysical benefit. That upsurge, that urge, is your heart expanding in that moment. Your heart really opening. You're not aware of it, but it's your heart opening all the way in that moment. You think it was just a rush of emotion or your heart opened more, but it's not more. It's completely. And then the act of it, the living it, cements that. Not meaning that your heart is completely open from then on all the time, but your heart has expanded if you act on it in ways you will probably not be aware of, but it'll show itself in your life. And it's not any different in small things than big things. Because it's the metaphysical actuality and the situation or the amount or what you do, how much help you give. It can be a small thing. You know, somebody asks you for help carrying a box to the car. It doesn't have to be a big thing. And I'm not saying every time somebody asks you for help carrying a box, I'm saying if you get a sudden rush of, I should do that, I want to do that, that's your cue that this is a metaphysical moment, an opening for you, a possibility has opened up. You never lose by giving. Even if you lose by giving, you haven't lost by giving. Even if you've given to the wrong person and they've taken advantage of you, you haven't lost. Even if it was a con artist and you really shouldn't have given, if the urge came and you followed it, you have not lost. because it's simply the urge to love. So you're practicing the ways of love rather than following the ways of unlove.